It's great to have you with us. You have an amazing payoff at your website because your website says smarter, faster, and cleaner than traditional construction. Shall we start with the smarter? How smart is John Snell?
Yeah, I think we are pretty smart, and indeed it's a good payoff. And why we're smarter is because we build almost 90% of the whole building in factory. And because we build it in factory, we can have, it's always on the controlled conditions. The quality is always at the same level. You have less skilled workforce. And of course, that's also a big challenge now to have the right people. And also if you do production in factory, you can repetitive do all the kind of works. And in that case, it is indeed smarter than how the traditional builders are building houses and apartments and buildings.
Now, we had a discussion this morning with a professor from Eindhoven and also somebody that was from Tel Aviv, Israel. And they were talking about construction 4.0, that we are going to implement more robotics. How do you see that? Is that also something that you are working on at Jan Snell?
Yeah, what you see is that, and that's also added, that's also linked. We've just been acquired, at least an important part of our shares acquired by a Japanese company, and there the industrialization and robotization is way ahead compared to Europe. And we also implementing robots for welding, for preparing walls, etc. And so I definitely can describe that will be the future. And we are already heavily investing in robotization. There's one remark on that, and that it is crucial that if you do the industrialization, there also is some need from standardization, and you keep a lot of flexibility. But there is also some standardization, and that is the kind of thinking that also should be there with the architects and with the people who buy the buildings and the houses, that they know that you need to start from the beginning if you really want to industrialize and robotize the processes in the building industry.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we totally agree on that, and all the other speakers that we had before say the same thing on that. But the second thing that you say is faster, so you are smarter and you are faster. But can you explain how faster you can build right now than traditional?
Yeah, we build around 30 to 50% faster, and in fact, the main reason is that. When you look at the building site, you need to start with the groundwork and the foundation, and then you start building the building. And what we're doing is, when we are starting with the foundation and the groundwork, we already producing our modules in the factory. So we do that in parallel, and when we are ready at the building site with the groundwork and the foundation, we can immediately start shipping the completely finished modules. And therefore we are much faster than the traditional builders.
And that's huge, because I heard one time up to, what, 90% of construction projects are delayed, something like that. So this is a huge chunk out of that. Amazing.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we have, because of that, the way we build, I think we are very clear about deadlines, and we do not miss deadlines. And the same goes also for our cost budgets. We always meet our budget, because we know exactly what we have to do. And as I said, 80 to 90% of all the work is done in factory. We can guarantee that the delivery time as well as the cost.
And I think that's what you like as a CFO, or not?
Absolutely. Some no surprises is always good. Yeah.
Time is money.
So then the last one is cleaner on your website. Can you explain what you mean by working cleaner, by cleaner?
Well, the circularity environmental issues that we're all facing, and we all know that, with the solution that we have, especially because of the 3D solution. So we prepare the whole modules, which means that if we build a house or an apartment or a building, that we can always, after the use we can always take the modules and reuse the modules in different places, different apartments, or reuse it in a way, and therefore it is in itself already very circular, and that's of course good for the environment. Next to that, because we produce in factory and we do all the work there, we have less transport costs, and transport emissions. And that's also a big benefit compared to the traditional production methodology, where they need to have a lot of transport costs to the building site. And we are in the cells, and that can also be, of course, also the traditional builders can do that as well, is to ensure that you use the right materials and put a lot of attention on that. But as I said, our product in itself is reusable, and I think that is already a big advantage versus the traditional builders.
Yeah, so you mentioned a couple of advantages that you have, but then the question is, why don't all construction companies build modular?
That is, as I said, of course, it is a kind of history. What you see happening now is that more and more also traditional companies are investing in industrialization. And what you see, you have, in fact, a kind of 2D solution, which means that they prepare floors in factory or walls in factory or roofs in factory and transport that towards the building and then prepare the building on the building site. And what we are doing, we are one step ahead, in fact, and we do 3D. So we produce the whole module. But what you see is also the traditional builders, they are investing in, at least for sure, for 2D solutions and try to produce these panels and walls in factory. So you see that happening more and more. And as I said, I think that also when the buyers and the investors, the social housing corporations, that they want to speed up the process, and I think that there will be more and more more and more demand for this kind of solutions.
So what is now the barrier that we need to tackle as an industry to move forward and to take it to the next level?
And I think that is the big challenge. I think, and we have the solutions with industrialization, robotization, and that will take the next 2 to 5 years, I think, a huge step. But we also need to be honest that the big challenge for our industry is that we need to get the permits, that we need to get the ground positions. And that's, in fact, not different from the traditional buyers for, builders versus the modular builders, because if you do not have the permits and if you do not have the land positions, you cannot build. And another thing which I think also in to solve that thing is that our solution, we could say, okay, maybe there's not a permit for a permanent permit, but maybe you can offer a temporary permit for 15 years. Which is easier to grant by the municipalities. Yeah. And then our solution can offer that building for 15 years, and then maybe in that period the municipality or the government can decide whether or not they want to extend it, and then you can leave the building for another 40 years, or that they say we want to use this for this plot for a different purpose, but then we can easily dismantle the building and put it somewhere else. So that's another advantage of modular. But the key thing for the real solution to build our 100,000 houses a year that we all want is that the government are giving permits and giving land position free to be able to build.
Yeah. So you also say you mentioned that already a little bit about circularity. Can you tell us a little bit more about how circular Jan Snell is building, on how circular modular building is?
In our factories, our waste is very, very, very limited. But next to that, our modules are always reused. So after the building is not used anymore, then we dismantle the building and reuse the modules for new buildings. So we are really circular. We also investing heavily in also optimizing our transport and also using transport that is less spending less gasoline, etc. And that is, I think, crucial for our industry to be really leading that, because the environmental issues that we face is huge, and again, I think that as a whole industry we need to invest heavily to do that. And as I said, for us, we are, I think, front runners because of the circular way of how we do our business and how we build our modules.
Yeah, and how is that about adding new, of making use of new kind of materials, maybe like wood or something else like materials? Are you also looking into that?
Yeah, we are indeed also looking into that. Our base product is, and that's also because of the demand and the people who are living in our houses, they still have that preference. Is that we have a concrete floor and a steel frame, and next to that we have wooden walls, wooden plafonds, and wooden roofs. So that's all with wood, and we have now also prepared an housing completely of wood. And what you see there, of course, you have some things about the possibility to really go high, which is it's a bigger challenge, and then you have with steel still the advantages. And the same goes a bit with the concrete floor. As I said, there are still people feeling with noise, etc., that it is better to have a solid concrete floor. But we are building that, and if the demand is growing, and we can also convince the users of the houses and investors that also wood is the right solution. We are ready for that. As I said, at the moment we do a concrete floor, steel frame, and the rest is wood.
Yeah. Well, and you mentioned already Daiwa House from Japan. They can probably help you a lot on the future. But what is your growth plan for Europe?
Yeah, for Europe, our growth plan is quite ambitious. It was already quite ambitious before Daiwa stepped on board with us at the beginning of this year. But what we see is as Jan Snell, we have a turnover of around 200 million. And we have two growth markets. It's the UK and Germany next to the Netherlands. And as I said, I think in the next 2 to 5 years we will triple our turnover. And I think that is a realistic target.
Amazing. Wow. Yeah. And then also looking into different kind of countries in Europe, or is the main focus those three countries?
Exactly what you said. The main focus now is for those three countries, because that if you want to be successful in this period, you also need to set up new factories in the UK as well as in Germany.
Yeah.
And I think after 3 to 5 years, we will further extend to the Nordics or to Eastern Europe, and from a maybe even longer term, maybe also go to Southern Europe. But that's a different culture, and therefore we prefer to stay in the let's say the UK, Benelux, Germany, and Eastern Europe for the next 5 years.
Cool. And what would your call to action be to all the real estate and construction professionals listening right now? What should they do?
Well, I think they should really start looking at our solution and the industrialization, and they should really think with having that in mind before they start talking with architect and preparing all kind of plans. Because if you get people like us on board in the early stage, you can together develop a product that is flexible, is looking great, is very efficient, is environmental friendly. And I think that's what they have to do. And I think together we need to convince the governments that they should give permits a bit more easy and provide those land positions to ensure that we can build all these beautiful houses and buildings.
Yeah, amazing. What is the most important lesson that you learned with all your conversations with the Japanese people on how they do construction and what we can learn here in Europe from that?
Well, I think the key thing, and that is where they are way ahead from us, is that standardization is something positive, and and you do not lose flexibility or beautiful architecture. And I think when we talk in Holland and in Europe about standardization, people think immediately, okay, you have no flexibility, you cannot make a beautiful building. And that is something what you learn, and also when you see how they produce it, that standardization and industrialization and robotization, it can come together with also some very beautiful architectural, nice buildings. And I think that is something that we need to convey that message also towards the industry here in Europe and in the Netherlands.
Yeah,
that came up in another session, right? Sometimes a little bit of restriction can actually give more freedom and a better outcome in the end.
Yeah, for sure. And then to end with the closing words of Theo Sellet, just do it because it's possible. Yeah,
absolutely, yeah. Absolutely.
Well, thank you very much, Richard Brinkman from Jan Snel. That was amazing to talk with you together about the future of modular building. Enjoy your day, and hope to speak to you soon.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.